Okay, let's see an example. It is given that voltage circuit inductance and resistance are 8 mH and 2000 ohm. What will be the percentage of error of the instrument when measuring an inductance load having a phase angle of 89 degree at 50 Hz? Okay, so let's see the solution. Beta is equal to 10 inverse of omega LP divided by RP. This is another way of calculating beta. Instead of using cos, you are using 10, because in NR formula we require 10. Okay, omega LP divided by RP, that is 10 inverse, 2 into 3.14 into 50 into 38 into 10 to power minus 3. Okay, divided by 2000. That will be the beta. So we want 10 beta. That is why 10 beta will be 1.25 into 10 to power minus 3. And it is given that it's an inductive load, 89 is the phase angle. So 10 beta will be 1089, that is 57.28. So the percentage error will be minus plus 1.25 into 10 to power minus 3, 57.28 into 100. That is 10 beta, 105, which will be 7.19%. And since it is an inductive load, which is a lagging load, that is why this positive is there. Okay. So percentage error will be this answer. Okay, so we have seen that including an inductor in pressure coil was producing a error result in wattmeter reading. So it was true reading plus some error quantity we were using, whether the load is leading or lagging. So we don't want that error term. If you don't want that error term, it should be compensated. The inductor effect should be compensated, and that is compensated by the capacitor in series. Okay, so whatever the value of L will be, the C will be chosen in such a way that it will nullify the effect of inductor, and the total impedance of this branch will become purely resistor. Okay, so that is what we will do. Zp is equal to small rp plus capital R plus j omega lp minus j upon omega c. This will be the impedance total here. So this small rp plus R is capital RP plus j omega lp minus 1 by omega c. So if we will keep this term 0, then your impedance of this branch will become purely resistive, which means your wattmeter reading will be same as true reading, and we won't have any losses. Okay, so in that case you can say the C should be chosen as 1 by omega square LP. But the problem is, since this relation depends upon frequency, we don't use this much. There is a better way of using a capacitor so that it will nullify the effect of inductor, that we will see next. Okay, so there is a better way to nullify the effect of inductor. So now you can see I have made a combined sort of thing, your big R and C. So this is the whole big resistance total. This was the big resistance. I have made it like a potentiometer. So capacitor is connected to R part of small r part of this big R, and the remaining is capital R minus small r. Okay, so this is how the arrangement, which is better than the previous one. So your Zp will be Rp plus j omega Lp plus R minus small r, which is this resistance, and the parallel combination of small r and C, R parallel 1 by j omega C. Okay, now if you simplify, Rp plus j omega Lp minus R, where Rp is small Rp plus R, plus R divided by j omega C, R plus 1 by j omega C. If you multiply and simplify, this is what you will get: R 1 minus j omega C R divided by 1 plus omega square C square R square. Now omega C R, if you will see, this is the quality factor of this R and C. So here I can replace 1 by Q square. Okay, now Q, you know, it's very very high, so 1 by Q will be very very less. So I can approximate this as 1 plus omega square C square R square. This is approximately equal to 1, since this quantity will be very very less. Okay, so what you will get is Rp plus j omega Lp minus R plus R 1 minus j omega CR, okay, which will be simplified further to RP, ZP is equal to RP plus j omega LP minus CR square. If you put this term as 0, you will get LP is equal to CR square, which means ZP will be equal to RP. So this will be the condition. LP, this is the inductance of pressure coil, is equal to C, this is C, and R square, small r square, which is this. So if you put the value C, or value of C with respect to this relation, your ZP will be equal to RP, which means your wattmeter reading will be true reading, okay. And you can see this does not depends upon the frequency omega, which is good. You can use it for any frequency. So that is how you can compensate the effect of pressure coil inductance. Now just like what we saw for error due to pressure coil inductance, sometimes you have a pressure coil capacitance as well, which will be CP, okay. So which will be CP, RP will be the resistance, IP is the current, IC is the current in the load branch, current coil, pressure coil, R, everything will be same. Just instead of inductance, you have now capacitance, okay. So what will happen? The expressions will be same, but what we had in capacitance case, lagging part will now be leading, and what we had for leading part in inductor case, now it will be lagging, okay. So they will replace. So lagging in inductor time, we had lagging case phi minus beta, which was less than phi, but here you have in lagging case phi plus beta greater than phi, okay. Similarly in inductor case, we had phi plus beta, which was greater than phi, but here in leading case you have phi minus beta, which is less than phi, okay. Rest all the things will be same. Cos phi plus beta will be less than cos phi. VI cos phi plus beta will be less than VI cos phi, which means wattmeter reading will be less than true reading. Here, cos phi minus beta will be greater than cos phi. VI cos phi minus beta will be greater than VI cos phi, which means wattmeter reading will be greater than true reading. Okay, and for compensating this capacitor, you can use the inductor. Thus, just the same way we used capacitor in case of inductor. Okay, so in the same manner, okay. So it is just to give you a flavor. If you have a capacitance instead of inductance, then use these things, okay. Rest everything will be the same. And when once you will use the resistance and capacitance both to compensate, then in the equal case, when resistance will compensate, inductor will compensate the effect of capacitor, or you can say capacitor will compensate the effect of inductor, it will be the branch will have ZP equal to RP. That's what we saw before, okay. So yeah, now just like we had connection error due to connection in DC power, we have something in AC power as well. So it depends upon how you connect the pressure coil, after current coil or before current coil. So you have two cases here as well. Okay, so the inductors, we will consider inductor only, okay, until I only stated that it's the pressure coil has capacitor. So here you can see the current and voltage across the load. Here also the current and voltage across the load, I and V. So in this case you will have, when your pressure coil is connected before current coil, then wattmeter reading will be VI cos phi plus I square RC, where RC will be the resistance across the current coil, okay. Here you will have wattmeter reading will be VI cos phi plus V square divided by RP, where RP is the resistance across the pressure coil, okay. So it's a similar thing, where PI cos phi is true power and wattmeter reading is there. So the I square RC and V square by RP are the error terms, okay, in case of AC. So this is very much used in the numericals I've seen. So please make use of these formulas mostly.